Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Mike. I'm your stage manager. Just wanted to take a quick moment to introduce all the principal singers to you. We'll just go down the line in order. Singing Meg, Kristen Chavez. You're so far away in this one. Ellie Dean, singing Alice. Marianne Cornetti, singing Quickly. Maureen McKay, singing Nanetta. Jonathan Johnson, singing Fenton. Roberto Candia, singing The Cider Roll, Falstaff. Troy Cook, singing R. Ford. Joel Sorensen, singing Dr. Caius. Simeon Asper, singing Bardolfo. And Reinhard Hagen, singing Pistola. Also wanted to introduce, if you haven't met him, our director, Olivier Tombosi.
Good evening. Our decision was that we have all singers completely naked. But
you'll want to see every performance.
But in order that it's not too offensive for you, we roll them in mud before they come on stage. And then we hang them upside down and they swing. Okay, so of course this is not true. We have recreated an English-Italian Renaissance feeling. There is a wooden set which envelops the singers from all sides, and it's made of wood, and they know the joke. I say in every rehearsal, it's made of legno di bel canto, of bel canto wood, which makes our voices resonate beautifully like the cage of a string instrument. And we try not to copy the historical period, but to recreate the feeling. So opera is not about showing you what life was like in the 1500s or 1600s. Opera is about once upon a time. This guy Falstaff, it's one of the roles that you cannot imagine in another age. We meet him as a fat old man. Now the audience loves this guy. You, as the population from Windsor, you do not love him. For you, he's a burden, he's a pest, he's terrible, because he comes to your house, he confiscates your food, he molests your wives and sisters and mothers and daughters, has no respect for nothing, and believes he has the right to do so, as he comes from aristocracy, and God-given rights are with him, which you, as simple citizens and farmers, do not have.
This is certainly a text-driven opera. So this requires, I would imagine, a different kind of sense of detail from you than perhaps if you were directing a La Traviata. It's a different kind of detail for you, right?
Directors have different styles. Mm-hmm. Some directors work with images, mm-hmm. and not very much happens with the person on stage. Mm-hmm. Some directors leave the images completely away and just work focused on the music. Not the singers do not do very much, the scenery doesn't change very much. So even in Traviata, I would search,
yes.
not to create some useless hyperactivity, it's not my goal, but also there I would search for the truth.
Now, immediately, Pistola, so we build something like, hey, what is this? Bardolfo, Tivola, Antola, Tivola, yeah? And now each of you who has a sentence tries to come very close and tell it to the others. Don't speak at Altobacchi Valai towards him, but what we say about him. It's un uomo, and he is fat, and he is impure. We say, can you see? So we share it to each other. And please always come close, and after your sentence, step away, then some other guy has a chance. So there is continuous change of movement. Devilish pleasure, like sticking it, like it would be needle sharp on one end, and you stick it already in his pleasure. Yeah, that's what we wanted to hear. I mean, tense tension in the whole body. Petica, petica. No.
Wagner made a big fuss about, that we bring now theater to opera, and Wagner said, you know, before me, opera was boring, it was just music and just voices, and now we connect it, we do the Gesamtkunstwerk. Without making so much words about it, Verdi was from his first steps in music theater doing the very same in his way.
Yes. This production really goes deeper into the score and the libretto and gives me the possibility to show the different size of... it's like a whole, having a whole pattern of colors in front of you. And then what Olivier asks me sometimes is to go deep into the real nature of the character that can be, at the same time, buffo, it can make you laugh, but also at the same time can make you think. Mm-hmm. And the complexity of the roles can be summoned in the fact that this old man is actually can be also like a small kid.
Sergio! Sergio! Servo, mi derrito, e dobbiamo andare tutti, rafali, finocchi, e sia la mia pastura, e volta occhi, Sansoni. E doppia l'avventura, venga anche lei, guardatemi.
He believes, he trusts, he is smart, he can do. And also physically, I must say, I've been doing for a lot of times operas like Barbarossaville and Nozze di Figaro and Mozart and Leporellos and things, operas where you have to jump here and there and move. But I must say, this old man is the most energetic I'm doing on stage. It takes a lot physically, and you will see.
Debut is a challenge anytime, right? It probably has different kinds of challenges because it's so ensemble driven. Can you talk a little bit about that? Like what the process is? I mean, learning a new role when it's so highly dependent upon ensemble.
It really is about this rhythm that just keeps going. So for example, my coach, when I put the music on the stand and he said, sit down, we are not even gonna sing a note for a week. And we put the metronome on, and there were moments I wanted to throw the score across the room, just getting the words, because it really is, the Italian is so intricate and involved. And if you have to learn every single person's line before and after you, just in case if you know something goes wrong, there's so much action happening on the stage, you have to really know everyone's part and your own and where that fits in and gels together.
Come on. This is very unlike any role I've ever done, and I wish I had a witty term for it. I have referred to it as a burp role. I'm not sure how appropriate that is, but I will describe what I mean. This role is not a large singing role. I have, you know, if you tacked it all up together, I sing not very much in the role. I'm on stage a lot. But my chief responsibility is really of support for the other characters and to help kind of fill in. So the thing that I'm doing is waiting for somebody to say the proper line, and then I stick my three words in. And then I'm quiet, and I'm acting, and I'm moving, and I'm filling in and helping and holding props. And then there's my other four words, and then I'm quiet. And then. So it's actually extraordinarily difficult to memorize a role like that when you're by yourself in a little room, and you're just hearing these little voices in your head. It's very challenging, but you know, one of the greatest pleasures about it is that I feel a little bit like a voyeur, or voyeuse, if you want to be correct, because I just get to basically, once I've, you know, subdued the panic of what's my next line and am I going to say it in time, and am I going to give my double consonants properly, once that's down, then I just get to enjoy everybody. It's comedy.
Yeah.
And many people have said to me, oh, Marianne, because of who I am, oh, you'll be great at this. Well, it's just not that simple. You know, because comedy is about timing.
Yes.
And what is my comedy in, or my spirit in my life isn't necessarily translated then over to the theater. And so you're trying to find these moments that are correct, batting your eyelashes or doing something with your hand or something like that to just sort of make it my own.
Mm-hmm.
And so it is hard. It is hard. But when you have a great director like this who allows you to do that, then it's okay.
This opera is theater before it's anything else.
Yeah.
Every element, every note, every rhythm, every tone, color, everything in it serves the drama of this piece. And, you know, it's all done for you. And that's where being an opera singer is different than being in, you know, doing straight theater. In straight theater, you have to create everything on your own. Mm. For us, everything is created for us, but then we have to figure it out. And it's like the reverse of how you put together a piece. that's our job, is to take something that's predetermined and make it seem like it's all completely organic and it's as if we are making it up off the top of our head and not giving away what comes next, if you know what I mean.
You have a very complicated roadmap for that that Verdi created for you.
Exactly.
But it's honoring that and then making it seem spontaneous.
Exactly.
And alive.
And making it seem like we're literally, all of us, the whole orchestra, everyone on stage, are making it up as we're going along. Musically, it's difficult, but it's difficult because the situations are so complex and multi-leveled, and the music certainly reflects that. And the thing that I like about this production is it respects all of those things and does it in a way that it's so clear to the audience. You'll be able to get it like that. And that's what we work and we do it over and over again until it's exactly right. And we do it so that you guys can sit and relax and just get the story.
The way the rehearsals were organized, because when we just arrived here, first thing we did were two musical rehearsals with the conductor that gives the first imprinting to the whole thing.
3, 4.
And then you go into the deep working with the director, with the conductor always present to the rehearsals. Because in that way, you can just have, at the beginning, a good set of what they are asking us, and then you can work on it.
One more time, alto. 1, 2, 1. Okay, ben, dai, two bar before, alzati. 1, 2, 3. Bene.
Alzati, hola!
Alzati, hola! Alzati, hola! Like this. Alzati, hola! The breath put together. 1, 2, 3, dai.
Alzati, hola!
I want to say that we are talking about an opera which is the summary of an entire life of Giuseppe Verdi. Mm-hmm. And I think that is not possible to conduct Falstaff if you don't have to conduct before, I don't want to say the other 26, but at least 15 Verdi's opera, because mm-hmm. you know it's a process that you where you have to arrive at the end of the idea at this huge and unbelievable career of this great maestro. Mm-hmm. And the difference is that this opera was written by Verdi just for fun, for himself. Mm-hmm.
Bottiglia di Jerez.
Respettata la mia giumenta vaia, portata la mia casa.
Non la tua massaia.
Troppa grazia.
The language of this opera is completely different. Yes. There are no closing numbers like it was at the beginning of the career. In a certain way, is really a modern way to think about the next century.
Yes.
One and two and one.
The score and the libretto are so easy to enjoy, but at the same time complex to get into it, to go deep into it for us as interpreters. And so every time you work on it and every time you put a little bit of yourself, a little bit of themselves into the role, and it creates a new debut. So that's why it doesn't count how many times you have done a yes. role like this or an opera like this, because it's like a debut every time.
When you ask us opera artists about what is your favorite opera, the standard answer is the one that we are currently working on.
Yes, right.
And of course this is true, but if I do a Flying Dutchman or a Tosca or a Trovatore or whatever, I'm very happy to do something else after it and switch and to have a variation. Not with operas like Mozart's Nozze di Figaro or Così fan tutte or this Falstaff by Verdi. In a letter that he wrote to Boito, the librettist, Verdi said, I regret in our music business that such an amount of composing and musical production and work on stage has become so unnaturally and so dishonest. And what I want, said Verdi, and what he tried to do with his Falstaff, to be very complex, put layer upon layer upon layer, and still stay accessible, stay communicating with an audience, and stay honest and natural, and that's what I find amazing in this opera.
Tutti gabbati,
tutti gabbati, tutti gabbati, tutti gabbati, tutti gabbati, tutti gabbati, tutti gabbati.
one of my favorite moments. I don't sing a word, but it's my daughter Nanetta's aria. Because there's so, we're just going fast and furious, and it's da-da-da-da-da-da-da in our conversations, and there's miraculous things happening. And then finally we get this gorgeous melody and this floaty pianissimi and the colors and the orchestra. It's just magical.